is that we've been conditioned to believe that these directors, these filmmakers, they are just these amazing creative geniuses. What they want us to see as official history is this whole thing like, okay, you already get stuck, you go back only as far as, like, so now you're dealing with, oh my gosh, you're stuck in the mindset of the emotional things that happened back in the day when we was being, you know, especially America has done that, yeah? And then we may have to seek a little bit beyond that to deal with maybe that there was universities in Timbuktu or, and then you're talking about Greek, about the Greeks were the ones that were the founders of civilization. And we know all of that is freaking lies, but that becomes the official stuff that is being put in the educational system that people even still teach today.
And ingrained in the fact,
even though the archaeologists would prove that this is not true, right?
Yeah.
But the point I'm making is that when you look at the movies are giving you the real story that they say people can't take. But when you're dealing with pure space stuff and beings from different constellations, and you're dealing with always having the beings on this planet under some kind of crazy, like, oh my gosh, invasion from these other beings, and then some of them, most of them are slaves, and some of them who you see are some movie, what do you call it, the ones who you see as the star in the movie, he is some kind of, he's playing either one of the good or bad guys for one of the aliens, you see, the alien groups.
Good cop, bad cop.
Yeah, so the point I'm getting is that they're putting these ideas in the movies that are really telling you about ancient Sumer, ancient Kemet.
Kemet.
Yeah.
Which they the gods of Egypt. Two hoodies, a black guy in there, and his little group, his clan. Yeah? Yo, bro.
Right.
Yeah, that's it. And he has to speak as
you know that. Yeah. He's a long time ago with that. What's her name? Elizabeth Taylor.
Right.
So he's speaking with this kind of over eloquent English accent as well. In Egypt,
like
in North Africa.
Right.
You know
like
what I'm saying? So you can see that they have, see what they're doing, because it's all about image and perception. And they can mess around with your perception through the image. Then they psychologically manipulate your consciousness, because consciousness is the creative principle. Yeah, it's the creator, your consciousness. And it's the substance of all matter. It's a substance of all things made visible. So this is where you get these gods outside of you. God up in the sky. God that is you know, you have to worship, otherwise you'll die.
Bow
all
down.
Of these times, bow down, all that stuff.
And surrender your own divinity.
There you go. Rather than acknowledge the source inside yourself. So now, slavery, working, all this type of stuff. This started back from the genetic manipulation, how you're doing. The genetic manipulation that was done here 450,000 years ago. And this is where you hear this thing, the mining the gold, mining in South Africa for the gold, and so forth. But here's this now. You've got the nature of who these beings is. And some people are saying what they call Anunnaki and Draconian Anunnakis. They're telling you that they were blonde hair, blue eyes. And maybe they were. I am not gonna jump and say we have a person who's talked about that way in the 90s that is considered crazy. But now you've got anybody can talk about that now, and it's like, oh, you're not gonna get, you know, threatened with being put in prison and all of this type of stuff, like you're going against the state, what you're doing, you know, talking about the truth of the nature of white people and black people and all of this type of stuff. But the thing is that there are beings, yeah, we don't originate from this planet, okay? And what the whole thing is, when you mess around with the DNA, you've got 3D, 3D is three dimensions of consciousness, when we originally had 12 dimensions of consciousness, yeah, minimum. Yeah? So we got a 12 dimension of consciousness that enables us to tune into any of those states. Like you got a broadband and you can pick up all of these channels, but someone's come along and cut that down and said, yo, because we need you to stay at a certain level so you don't rise above us, and so you can stay keeping the burden of the gods on your back, which was mining the gold. You see what I mean? Hence gold standard, and who gives gold this value? Such a value, where did it come from? Gold didn't say, I'm so valuable, y'all. people gave it. Who was these people? So when we chat about the gods and the devils and gods and mortals, which is very much in Greek mythology, you're dealing with the actual reality that we had beings come down into this planet many, many, many hundred thousand years ago. Sounds ridiculous, but it's okay, we can make movies about it. Yeah? Because it's only entertainment. Yeah? But this is where the manipulation began. They messed around with our DNA. We can't tune in, but we can now. We're in a time now, it's called a stellar activation cycle, where you're able to now, the photonic energy coming into this planet is what they're talking about, activating your DNA. Yeah? Why is there so much interest in the DNA, the genome, all of this project and all of that? Because the genes can come back online. What they're calling junk DNA are the 9 levels that they unplugged, yeah? Which would make the 12 with the 3 that we already got going on, that puts you in alignment with Christ consciousness, or Christ consciousness, avatar awareness.
If you recalibrate.
Yeah.
So let me put it so forward,
this,
right?
There's the opportunity now for that.
Yeah.
But just saying, and I'm gonna leave you, man, and you carry on and take the rest of
that. He's gonna carry on. Exactly on that. But the only thing, the only thing I need to see, I'm just gonna rewind for some of y'all who didn't catch it, but he's breaking bad about the movies, right? Good point. Now the movies, right? In order to mock the truth, you must know the truth. So when he's talking about Steven Spielberg and all them, they elevate on a certain level where they're seeing those beings in that paradigm. So they can come with that. So back to his point, like the original Star Wars is like most of us in kindergarten, right? Or elementary school, 1978. So that idea must be really conceived in 1968. But even still, it was the green light versus the amber light, right?
Okay.
So when you're saying like Illuminati is not a negative word. It's just, it's one scale of the polarity of it. Like, what's the difference between hot and cold water? The mere fact that an individual, if I ask that question, they're deliberating what's the difference between hot and cold water, there's no difference. It's two polarities of the same thing.
Yeah, two extremes.
So, we got to get to that equal balance, or what you're saying now, equilibrium. So, in order to mock the truth, you must know the truth. So, you know that when you was growing up, all these animations, when it's coming through, the enemy of the planet Earth always looked what? Green and scaly. This goes back to my point. Hey, yo, that motherfucking soul hanging in the back like a... Anyway, right? This goes back to my point, right, earlier. What type of sessions again? Goes back to my point earlier, right? That I lost my train of thought right there.
You were talking about how he's dealing with
green, scaly skin.
And the moves, right? In order to mock the truth and all that. So they gave us these images, right? And the enemy was always like reptilian. But we took that in a child's cartoon, plain to see. No argument. You always see the enemy, right? Do you remember a program called Space 1999? Where they could ship shape. They were showing you ship shaping right there.
Was it Space 1999 or V?
1999.
Or was it V?
V is a good one. But let's look at Space.
Yeah.
Yo, D, you remember Space 1999?
I remember Space 1999.
Space 1999, right? And it could change to a lion, eagle.
Check the prominent. They changed to a lizard.
Check the prominent. Yeah, so check the prominent symbols I'm saying. A lion, an eagle, a serpent. All the prominent signs we had in Kematology, right? But Space 1999, right, was so called Mark the Change of the Millennium, right? Hear me. What was the base called?
The what?
The base. Moon base
moon
what?
Base al-
moon base.
Moon base Alpha.
Let's go to the Greek now. Moon base Alpha 12.
Moon base Alpha 12.
Moon base Alpha 12.
Yeah, I didn't remember that bit, you know what I mean?
But to that. I remember everything. And the brains on our side.
And we're chatting about 12. Right, and Alpha is supposed to be the first.
And last up,
yeah?
And all that.
And hence that, when they're able to do all of that shifting, it is indicating that what we were able to do before we were interfered with genetically is the fact that we could tune into all the different dimensions naturally. That's what reincarnating here. Dude, we didn't come here to suffer. We come here as an experience, an expression of the soul.
And that
to understand the manifestation and incarnation.
That intertwines with my man's point.
You know what I mean?
When he mentioned like some minutes ago about the DNA and the manipulation going on and how we fall victim because we're letting them slip through us through the RNA, compromising the very integrity of the DNA. And you don't know right now, they come with a new thing called GNA, which is glycerol nucleic acid, which is artificial nanobiotechnology, right? So they're trying to forcibly interface you with transhumanism,
what they call it, AI, artificial intelligence.
Yeah.
Nobody even can keep an eye on you. Don't check that shit out.
And that's gonna come through the food. So that's why food, my shit here, I'm not playing no games. The health and nutrition is first and foremost on my table. And then you can work your way out, you wanna talk about green ingredients? Come on. I used to be green. I can wear that on all day. However, I'm gonna deal with your physical condition first.
Some people don't agree to spice something.
And I want to deal with your constitution first. The real revolution is your constitution first and foremost.
Yeah.
And that's not backing up so-called Darwin's evolution theory, which you know is a fraud. I'm not dealing with like revolutions and fraud of fiscal. We're talking about algorithm, but that's another story.
Well, I'm going to say before I go, maybe a little bit different to my brother's flow, but what it is just what I think y'all should know. That it's not about getting caught up on
semantics of the words.
Not just that, but it's not about just getting caught up at all on this. Yo, bro. Getting caught up on, you see, this thing with race and black and white and this and that. Don't get your mind caught up in all that.
Energy.
Don't get caught up in none of that, because this is all the dissension and the separation.
It would take you off the path.
And you'll miss the real thing. It's nothing to do with all
you
of this.
You would let go of the rope.
It's not about all white people do this, because it's black folk that do this one freaking crazy crap.
Yeah.
Yeah?
And ain't right? A black and white thing.
You know, that we can turn around and be saying all white folk is. So let's get rid of that rubbish.
Yeah?
Because that's what's also implemented to create these force enemies, so we will be distracted from seeing what the real thing is by going into ourselves and waking up to our true connection to the source of all that is. But this is really ultimately what this is about. Because from the time we were genetically manipulated, our awareness, our attention has always been drawn outside of ourselves, away from the inner being. And when you're looking outside of yourself, this is how they can create buildings for you to worship. Because all the megaliths, pyramids, kekalus, they call obelisks and so forth, they were created for a purpose, to be conduits for energy. Cosmic energy, everything's moving on electrical energy, cosmic energy. Yeah? We think with electrical impulse, we feel with magnetic impulse. So we would have things that would enable that energy to come through into the planet, always refreshing it, rejuvenating it. You could go to places wherever you want to go and just hang and allow this energy to bathe you. This is the reason why they created various centers that would be able to be conduits for this cosmic energy. You see what I mean?
To back that up, you know what I told you last week about Iron Hill Grand, what it's needed there for? It's conduit to what? Copper and iron produces what?
Copper and iron.
The friction of it produces
electricity.
You're electric beings. All this stuff that we seeing, we thinking it's cool, learning, saving down, all that. You gotta put it into practice, like put it in practice application.
But the thing is,
your outline.
The thing is, yeah, the thing is with the electricity, it's there. What you're doing with the copper and iron is what generates it, enables it to give it a conduit again to flow. You see what I'm saying? But it's all there. It's all moving through. You got creative life force energies moving through us all right now. All holy but frequencies are moving through us right now. You see what I mean? So what I'm saying is that everything, we are itself a conduit of cosmic energy. We are a conduit. We have direct connection to the universal source. The universal spirit. Universal source. What we want to call it. And when we were manipulated, it was orientating us outside of ourselves. So when you're directing your energy, you're directing your energy to these structures now, which these people, whether whoever are the head of these religions, they suck up your energy. They become, all right,
a way of
understanding how this is without it seeming really non-scientific or so forth. You stand on a stage, anyone who knows what it feels like being on stage and having all this attention,
you feel it.
So therefore, you're feeling this living energy that you can either feed off it or you can become addicted to it. If you're not generating that energy yourself to give back to the crowd to also have that energy come back to you. But if you're depending upon just the externalization of it, and you're just like, oh, I love you, and you're feeling all the energy. But you're not generating none of that, and you go somewhere else, and you're not gonna be as adored as the other place you went and hanged out, then you're gonna feel shit. You're gonna feel you're not receiving the energy. So the point I'm making is that just by that, you can feel the energy. So when we're putting out energy, it's a real thing. It's a real thing. You see what I mean? It depends.
depends what you're taking in. All I'm saying, oh, well, it can't be. I mean, look.
Unless
look,
you cleanse your energy.
And you calibrate.
Yeah, and what, I mean, look, energy. It's like if you're putting out positive energy, you will receive positive energy. It's fine. But what you're saying is correct because it should make people understand that what you're putting out, you're in a state, your vibrational rate of consciousness or state of consciousness. If you're internalizing a lot of anger and hatred and resentment, you know, you've got those lower type of frequencies going on. It doesn't just stay in you. This stuff is emanating from you, and then it hurts people. And you know, you can feel, you can even walk into a room where someone's
just had a
terrible
you're going to put that in somebody's
and
side.
And you can feel it.
Or you could feel good about yourself.
So if you get that sucked up and you get and you absorb that, this is the reason why people as who are dealing with spiritual counteractions of these type of things and aware of the sensitivity of energies, that we are sensitive.
Yeah.
You go in a bath, man, and you have a bath to wash and cleanse yourself from those negativities that you've been absorbing so into your body. So you don't have that carrying, then it changes you. It changes your energy and the way you feel and the way you think. And you now become just like that crap. So you go through these cleansings, for example, like that, to draw that negativity out of you. Okay? So you're lighter again and you can realign and collaborate yourself with your energy. But your energy is always directed by the way you think and feel. Alright? The way you think and feel. So this is really about the higher level of where we need to be being aware of. Now, it's not about getting caught up in all of these old freaking 60s and 50s of a war and all the white people, this and all this thing. Yeah? It's all bullshit because they've been, actually everyone's being manipulated here. Everyone. You see what I mean?
That point.
So it's about empowerment, spiritual empowerment.
So as you know, that emotion is energy emotion, right? So feedback to kindergarten, you have an argument with your girl, right? She may be exercising lives, I want to be nice and political. A peace, right? Not that good, better word, for the better word, nice word. So you this home go out, you're like, yo, whatever it is, right? But then you feel bad, you're an epiphany, right? That moment in time. What do? You say, you know what? Sorry, I take that back. But the mere fact you declared you take that back, you literally took that back. You took the energy back. Right. You took the invocation back.
Right.
However, if you don't take it back, you know how many people like go on to have crazy lives and insecurity when they grow up? Because it was called fat, this, that, and the third. Because you didn't take it back, you didn't release it to check yourself.
Right.
So that's real what he was saying. Real talk. When I'm saying real talk, you know, my real talk is not R-E-A-L-T-A-L-K. That's what's been on you. Real talk is like energy. Real as in this is a move. You can fast forward, pause, or stop. You got a star in there. Real talk to me is like real as an emotion. As in R-E-A-L and a talk.
R-E-A-L-T-A-L-K.
So real talk, take the energy back. You did somebody, take the energy back, man. Come on. You know what I'm saying? Don't be like so egotistical that you can't take it back. Be the better person, or they say the better man, the better woman is your girl, that's the same. Take the energy back.
Just inject there, that will make it a move.
Right. So great.
Because we are
racism.
Racism, as we explained earlier on, you wasn't hearing it, Bob. Racism really is nothing to do with black and white. Racism is a class act. It's a haves and who, and haves and haves not. Racism has never been about black and white. It's about financial gain. Do some research on a real world basis.
I was going to say, well,
nobody wins the race in racism. I like to say
here it is.
That.
And that's what others have said. The thing with race, even the word of
race.
It goes, there's a language is older than
Greek
and Latin, and even older than what, you know, some people be talking about as Sanskrit and so forth, okay? You know, you've got Kemetic, you've got Geese, but even older than that, man.
Yeah.
All right? So in the older, more ancient language, the word races meant holders of light.
Oh, Ra, oh yes. Ra.
Now, so what?
Pause. I gotta get this in. I'm gonna leave you to it. I gotta pause and get you into it. I should have seen you.
Bro.
You know, I didn't even know. No, this is bad. This is what we do. We build a cipher, right?
Right.
Now, what I told you earlier on, and yesterday, and the day before that, about the word chakra, and we're gonna give these Hindus back their shit. I said, it's what? Metal natural? What? Shakumshin Ra. Shakumshin Ra. Oh, happy testing. Anyway.
He's on point.
So many words, but it's our languages.
But the thing is this.
He's looking astonished.
But the thing is this. If we get caught up on language, you must understand the essence of the thing. Because you have knowledge that has come out from a source and moved out in multiple directions. So because other people may call the same thing different ways,
I don't agree that we need to kind of get caught up in, yeah, all of that. Just know that, well, what they're talking about, the same thing we're talking about, just that they have different terminologies for the same thing. It's not about, oh, that's our stuff. And then what comes from source goes, it's universal, you understand? The sun doesn't shine on just, you know, one dog's ass or one person.
So racism is universal?
It goes everywhere. No, racism is a con, okay? Racism, the real thing about racism
is it related to raw?
It related to light and consciousness. So therefore what it is, you're dealing with races really represent the holders of consciousness. Each so-called collective came and has a part of the race we have down here, right? We're holders of consciousness. We come here to we represent something. Each race represents
represents a level of consciousness
that we all here in the country.
Right, okay,
but
they've
taken the name races and make it to be like a competition.
Right,
yeah? Who's gonna get to friggin' top? And you know, no
hope
bar. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
and there's only one winner. Yeah?
There's only
one winner of a race when you're dealing with that type of race.
Right.
So this is where you end up having to divide and keep people in competition with each other rather than understanding their unity and oneness with all life. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, because it's about you can manipulate and control people the more they're disconnected, the more they're frightened. And all these illusions, of separation.
How many races? You think the same number as a chakra? How many races?
According to some source of info that I'm coming from, when you're dealing with this planet, I mean, there was four original races. Yeah? Four original races.
Which four?
Well, they're talking about if you're going to turn around and... Because, see, what happens, people want to know who's the better race who came first and what are that type of stuff. You got the red, white, yellow, right?
You always
got red, white, yellow. Yeah?
Check the timeline.
Red, white, what is it? Red, white, yellow.
Always does things.
And there was another one, and black. What am I talking about?
Johan.
Johan.
So cool.
But they'd be represented as blue. You see, if you go into the Navajo or you go into certain Native American Indians, you know what you're dealing with the Hopi Indians? They got a story about the four divine races. You see what I'm saying? You got all different cultures got the ancient races.
Allegedly.
Before we're talking about what we're thinking as race and dealing with fighting and all of that business, okay? And why we must hate this one and all of that. All of this is sensitive. All of this stuff is dealing with the manipulation that's come here on this planet to keep people warring with each other, while those who are doing the manipulation, they just reap all the life force.
Who's doing that? Who are these people that are doing all the bad stuff? Don't do that here.
Because
don't ruin the scholarship.
How many? Three times.
All right, all right.
What are you doing?
Look at his dress. That's his own agenda.
He's
like one of the rabbis.
Bullshit. Right? Don't do that right here. You know don't do that right here. Get your own arena and do that. I'm gonna blast every time you do that shit. I'm not doing anything. I'm asking.
I'm on a video. Young fellas, he does that.
He does that.
And if you get you on a race,
and what one is?
I see three.
You can come on for that, dude. Because you see, that's showing you that there are also
grown men,
who fuck with the scholarship out here.
Come around and
sabotage.
I'm gonna blast them with the whole video on
the real
cayenne.
The real mission.
And I was being nice last week
amongst, you know,
being nice people.
Some black
mental health issues.
As well.
No.
Yeah, you got black folks.
He's an agent. He doesn't realize he's an agent. I'm being real right now. He wants to do that shit every time he go positive. You saw that before, right?
It's your state of consciousness. It's your state of consciousness.
He's doing that on purpose. He brings it all down. What he's like,
somebody else's
children can be baking gingerbread men, and I come along and say, yo, look at the children. They bake some gingerbread men. They had fun. He'll come along and say, yo, but look at the mess they made. That's what he comes with. That's his agenda. His agenda's always been about that. Anytime you see construction news, he try to bring that shit down and try to trap everyone in racism and shit that don't exist.
You don't want
to go down.
You don't want
none
of that.
Shit. We're not about that.
We don't want none of that.
And we're not about none of that.
And if you was to look back in certain things with all
we're
the
things
that's
different
going on
paradigm now, right now, but you can't even grasp that.
I mean, check this out, dude.
Monkey
look, look at this sister.
I'm
look at her,
blasting.
Look at her complexion. Look at your complexion. Look at his complexion. Look at mine. Look at this. Within our own people, we got freaking complexion wars. So, this is some bullshit.
And he want to bring that into. Why did he throw that into the mix?
You know
why did
Why did he bring that? Look at his straps. Film this shit. No, film this shit.
You see?
Yo, fuck that. I'm real, man. Watch this. There's no escape, man. Fuck that. Watch. Watch. We had such a positive cipher, and you came in and messed that up? Now it's on you. What is this shit? What is this shit?
Yo, Lieutenant.
Answer the man's question. Yeah, Christian here. Christian is coon. Where did he get his shoes from? Answer the man. You are a coon.
It's secret.
Secret. So you're in a secret society, right? You're in bed with them. Secret society, right? Can anybody join? Or is it your exclusive club? Are you a black policeman? Are you purporting to be of the law? Is this shit? Yo. Put his ass on, man. I'm tired of this. He jumps on every motherfucker's video and puts negative comments. I had enough of that shit. I banned him 3 times from my page. Him and my brother's farewell page, him and my brother Polar's page, him and my brother Young Marcus' page, on Sonetta's page, him and Mikey's page, on Solomon's page, him and everybody's fucking page. He's gotta be blasted up. Asking the question, where did he get this shit? What is this? What is it? Is this fancy dress?
No,
what's this, Halloween?
Listen.
Is this Halloween?
He's speak.
Your costume is meant to reflect your custom. Is this your custom?
No, it's beautiful.
Come on, man. Don't do that. Wait, don't co-sign this coonery.
No,
my friend, don't co-sign.
That is my own son. Freedom of speech. Freedom of expression.
Which you're entitled to.
Right, good.
Go ahead.
Hey, let me say something. You see this thing?
But you're co-signing his coon foonery.
Yo, dude.
This is coon foonery.
You see this thing?
Period.
This thing? That's not freaking peace. That's the vision. The ancient symbol for peace was this, dude.
No. Exactly.
Yeah. It's
peace.
Exactly.
Give me all this motherfucker.
Well, bomb. And even that.
Good.
And even that. But he don't know. He don't know about that.
And victory.
He don't know about that.
Okay.
Peace and victory.
Two of them.
Yeah, you got it.
Two of them. What? Two of them.
Peace
two of them.
And victory.
Lack of knowledge of
that's
self and kind. That's
peace
real. Real talk.
And victory for everyone.
That's what happens. Shiv.
Right,
yo. 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 That's what happens when you surrender your divinity. Look. Look.
See, that's power.
This is what happens when you surrender your divinity.
The
power,
they're complimenting each other, man.
Yeah. Go for it. Look.
That's unity.
That's not unity. That's stupidity.
No, that is.
That's not unity. That's stupidity. Ah, said it.
That's fancy, man.
These two monkey ass. Come on.
That's right. For justice.
Yeah. You're co-signing each other's ignorance. You're co-signing each other's ignorance.
Oh man, this is.
And I still get your poster. You're co-signing each other's ignorance. That's not unity. That's stupidity.
Oh, man. But what you were saying?
What is this? What is this? Man. Foolishness, yeah, man.
But that's powerful. That sign.
God damn, yo.
Six and an eight. That's six and an eight.
Remember all symbols.
Hi, princess. How was your day today? You good?
Good.
Alright, you should have took part.
Huh?
Next time, beautiful goddess, you definitely coming on film because you got more intelligence than some of these so-called adults. You know that, right?
He's asking me about symbols,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, serious.
And symbols are symbolic.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
But symbols are symbolic. It's a language. Yeah. It's a language of the soul. But I'm not going to break this down the way he wants to break it down.
Yeah, he's like, trying to trap you, right?
This is what I'm going
to
show you.
Listen
to this,
baby.
This is what I'm just going
to
simply
say. Well, listen
right?
To
this is what I'm simply going to say. Overstand that all symbols like this are geometric forms created by sound vibration.
Listen to this.
Right. Sound and light is the language of the universe.
Wahadifa. Right.
When we start to look at symbols that get taken out of its context, like the swastika, for example,
right.
Or you see in the 6-point
which was
star,
positive,
you associate with the Jews.
Right.
And
yeah. Inverted
we then through association, image and perception, we then start to project a lot of stuff on these symbols which has got nothing to do with them.
Right.
We may start to think that's satanic because someone chose to use the swastika in a negative way.
Yeah.
Or we may turn around and think, oh, the six-pointed star, that must only be dealing with the Jews and you must be dealing with that type of stuff. When that, they ain't the origin, they ain't not the originals or originators of those symbols. When you study sound and light, when you're dealing with, there's a science called,
Wahadifa.
Well, you can say Wahadifa.
Sound healing,
different words for the same thing.
Exactly.
But the semantics, what that is, it is dealing with sound frequencies and how specific sound frequencies produce sacred or certain geometrical shapes. Okay? Certain geometrical shapes. Okay? And these certain geometrical shapes will have the power of what that sound represents.
Right, okay.
Each sound has a color.
Right,
each sound has a shape.
Yeah.
Each sound has a frequency to it. So everything's got a vibrational frequency. So if you was to change change and manipulate that frequency, you'll manipulate the form.
The form
of
yes.
that thing.
And the shape.
And
of the geometrical shape that's related
right.
to
if
it.
You,
right,
if you
okay.
mess around with the frequency. So
right,
you're
right.
dealing with what is related. Everything is interconnected and related.
Right.
So